insertion of complete denture. Denture insertion in the fringed denture must fulfill physical needs required to perform adequate function without trauma to supporting structures, physiologic need to allow proper support by muscles for good aesthetics, psychologic needs to provide proper function and aesthetic. Objective of denture insertion: to identify and correct any area of denture base causing pain or discomfort, any area of denture interfering with retention and stability of the denture, any part of denture that is aesthetically unpleasing, to modify occlusal surface to harmonize occlusion, refine occlusion, to instruct the patient how to use and care his denture, to instruct the patient in proper care of denture supporting tissue, to advise the patient on limitation of denture to be expected. Insertion procedure including extraoral examination of the first denture, which including examination of impression surface, evaluation of denture border, evaluation of polished surface, intraoral examination of the first denture, which including location and relief of pressure area in denture base, identification and reduction of overextended borders, evaluation of retention and stability, evaluation of aesthetics and facial contour, refinement of occlusion, patient instructions. The instrument and the material needed for this step: low speed contrav with acrylic pair, stone and disc, articulating papers, pressure indicating paste or white paste of zinc oxide, cover and knife, rubber bow containing water and cotton roll. Is the unit, you must have low speed, stone, disc, a pressure indicating vest, articulating paper, knife and carver, and rubber band containing water. First of all, when you frame your denture, you have to know why we make this step. This step is very important to check any abnormalities regarding the fitting surface, like sore spots, pressure area, any roughness regarding the periphery or the polished surface, and check also the aesthetic or phonetic regarding the patient approval to the denture, and give the instruction, limitation, uses of the denture. First of all, in this step, you have to check the upper denture alone. First, check the fitting surface. The fitting surface must be free from any irregular area or sharp area or pressure area, which make any problem to the patient, and this we can check by using what's called the pressure indicating vest, and we'll discuss it later inside the patient mouth. Second part, you have to check the periphery and border of the denture. All the border of the denture must be well finished, round, rolled, smooth, and all the frenum must be well opened. Regarding the anatomical structure, you recorded during secondary second impression stage. And finally, the polished denture must be also highly polished or finished, no porosity founding in the denture. The same for the lower denture. Also, we check the fitting surface from any pressure or sore spot. We check the periphery and the frenum opening. We check the polished surface must be highly polished with smooth and no porosity. And in the same time, upper and lower denture must be checked regarding the gingival work, stabling, and interdental papillae well prepared according your waxing up stage. Later on, you have to put the denture in your rubber bowl. This step helping to add retention by physical means like ladition and cohesion, and help in breath also. Also, inside the patient mouth, we will insert the upper denture alone and make check to the upper denture only. Here, we will check first the retention. The retention, as we all of us know, we ask the patient first to swallow. Then, the denture is well adapted. Try to fix the retention by trying to withdraw the tissue away from the, Then, we will check the border extension by asking the patient to limit the mouth opening. you make 45 degree reflection of the cheek and lip, and if any high increase in the length of the border will be detected, the denture will be dropped, and also by inspection of your eye. The same for the other side. We show here that in the buccal area, the distal buccal corner, here the distal buccal corner is slightly overextended. If you didn't have to mark this step, you can remove the denture from the patient's mouth. Small amount of the white paste of the rubber of the zinc oxide eugenol. This mean can help you to detect if this border is overextended really, or your reflection is not good. When we put this amount of white paste inside the patient's mouth and they make slight reflection, if the white paste removed, this means that the border is overextended. We'll check it in the patient mouth. Make 45 degree reflection and make training. And I will remove the denture. As we show here, amount of the rubber, of the white paste have been removed from this border. This border is overextended and need to reduced with low speed contrast. By using the low speed and the stone, you have finished, you have to reduce this part slowly from which the white paste is removed to reduce the height in this area, the height of the flange. Then a small piece of cotton, you have to remove the white paste that we use it to check the extension and clean the denture from this area to check if you reduced enough or need to reduce more height from the flange. In the patient mouth after reduction of the lens, you have to ask the patient to slowly open the mouth, if it's way hug, if it come in, and the 45 degree reflection already have shortening, and there is a small space created. The same here, we check the frenum, buccal frenum, liberal frenum, also the other buccal frenum. All the frenum for the upper arch will open in their position. The midline, the upper denture, with the midline of the face first, with the midline of the philtrum, with the midline of the frenum, shifted or not here, it's adequate in the right position. We'll check the profile of the patient from lateral view. We have to choose that the upper denture make no stretching to the mesolabial fold, and all wrinkled here have been supported with the upper denture. And also from the front view, we'll check the appearance of the teeth, the amount of teeth showing when the patient slightly smile, but, and the amount of the color of the shade used for the teeth. And finally, we'll check the occlusal plane of the upper denture by asking the patient to open the mouth if they hug. We'll check that the both occlusal plane are in the same level, no one higher than the other. And the teeth are in the crest of the ridge. This is for the upper denture. The same step made for the upper denture also will be made for the lower denture inside the patient mouth. The lower denture. First, we check the tongue space. If the lingual border is overextended, when you ask the patient to raise the tongue, it will be elevated. And then we will check the extension buccally and labially, also by 45 degree. And check the frenum opening here. The frenum is good open. Will the denture not overextended or underextended? We will check the stability of the lower denture by alternative pressure. The denture is stable. We'll check the setting of the teeth posteriorly in the crest of the ridge and the end before the retromolar bed, the anterior to third, and the occlusal surface for the lower teeth of the anterior teeth is with the commissure of the mouth or the angle of the mouth or the canine lines, not higher than the vermilion border. And also, I check that the teeth, the posterior teeth, not sit, the setting of the posterior teeth not so lingually to cramp the tongue space. If this posterior teeth is setting more lingual, the tongue will be cramped and nostrils for the tongue, so the patient will have difficulty in speech. Also, in the same time, the teeth must be so buccally to avoid cheek biting. Then we'll remove the lower denture. Now, we will check the upper and the lower denture together in the patient's mouth. And in the insertion of the upper denture. First of all, I will check the vertical dimension of the denture by asking the patient to swallow and make slight thing M. اقفل يا حاج اقفل بالراحة اقفل كمان كمان ريح شفايفك خالص خالص قول كده M
M
and check if there is space between the upper and the lower denture or no. If there is space, this is called the freeway space. It is the difference between vertical dimension of wrist and the vertical dimension of occlusion and must be exist the denture. If the freeway space not present, the patient will have difficulty in speech and the mastication. I will check the vertical dimension by asking the patient to close and open and check the movement of the mandible. اقفل يا حاج اقفل افتح كده بالراحة. The movement of the mandible is easy, not take difficult in movement. اقفل. I will check the amount of teeth showing when the lip are in rest position. We show in the patient to have a slightly short lip and large amount of teeth appearing. And we'll now check the center collision by asking the patient to open the mouth and guide the mandible to the rest position. افتح يا حاج لسانك ورا في سقف حلقك اقفل. And repeat this step to check that is this the perfect wrist centriculation or the habitual position. افتح يا حاج لسانك ورا واقفل اقفل. As we show, the centriculation is in the same position each time. Now let's check the occlusion between the upper and the lower denture. There must be even occlusion between the upper and the lower denture, no high spot. And this we check it with using articulating paper like this. This is articulating paper, is put in the fitting surface of the lower denture. افتح يا حاج. On both sides in the same time. اقفل and ask the patient to close in centriculation several times. افتح. اقفل. افتح. اقفل. افتح. اقفل. Now I will remove the articulating paper. افتح يا حاج. And remove the denture from the patient mouth. There must be a spot like this, but not highly cleared. The high spot indicated by eye camel that containing one dark spot and surrounded by one white spot. Here, as we show, maybe appear here on the cusp of the seven. And also this is a pressure area on the tip of the canine. I will make selective grinding to this according to Ball rule. I will remove the old mark of the articulating paper from upper and lower denture and place the denture again in the patient mouth. And I will put the articulating paper again. افتح. اقفل لسانك ورا اقفل. You must be sure that the patient close each time in the centric position, not habitual position. افتح يا حاج. And I will check again. We show here that is the same point between the lateral and the canine still high spot. And here another high spot present on the center of the upper four. I will remove it again with the loose beads. Here we finished the selective grinding and all the teeth are in even contact. And we asked the patient that he feel the bite in one side more than one side or no. The patient say no, is the both sides are even. We will check the patient approval. We ask the patient as he's satisfied with the shade, with the size of the teeth, with the facial appearance. You have in this step you have to have mirror to give it to the patient and let him to show your work. Okay. شكل السنان كويس عاجب حضرتك؟
كويس ما فيهوش حاجه.
طيب والكلام تمام مريحك؟
تمام.
طيب واللون برضك تمام؟ مفيش اي مشكله؟
لا
ناو after finishing and polishing of the denture we insert the patient mouth and check if any problem annoying the patient. قفل. And now we'll give the patient some instruction.
طبعا بعد ما خلصنا كل الستيب بتاعت الانسيرشن وتأكدنا ان الدينشر تمام في بوق العيان، لازم تعرف العيان عن الانستراكشنز اللي هو على اساسها هيستخدم الدينشر بتاعه، وتعرفه كمان ازاي يقدر يعمل هايجين للدينشر والاورال كافيتي. اول حاجه في الحاجه اسمها الهابيتويشن اند الابيرنس، ان لازم تعرف العيان انه في البدايه هيحس ان في حاجه غريبه بالكي كبيره موجوده في الاورال كافيتي، وان الاحساس ان هو التشيك بتاعته واللب فيها يعني حاجه عامله لها فوجز او سبورت جديد عن ان هو كان موجود من غير موجود الدينشر في البيشنت ماوس. في نفس الوقت ان المصل بالذات المصل بتاعه التانج اللي هي باورفل المصل هتحاول تعمل ديسبليسمنت للتانج باي طريقه، لكن مع الوقت الدينشر ده هيبقى بارت من الاورال كافيتي ومش هيقدر يستغنى عنه، وهيبقى الاحساس بوجود الطقم حاجه طبيعيه جدا. ان في البدايه عندنا هيبقى عندي اكسسيف سالايفيشن، يعني اللعاب هيبقى زايد، ده حاجه ان هو وجود حاجه زي فورم بودي في البقره الكافيتي فالسلايفا بتكتر، فبعد كده بيحصل ان هو السلايفري فلو بيرجع للنورمال بتاعه من 2 ل 3 اسابيع. ان كمان الايتنج هابت بتاعته ان الطقم غير الناتشرال تيس خالص، يعني ما ينفعش ياكل ستيكي فود، ما ينفعش ياكل كميه اكل كبيره مره واحده، ان هو في البدايه خالص لازم يبتدي ان هو يقطع الطعام لاجزاء صغيره ويحطها على بوث سايد اوف ذا الاورال او على ناحيتين الاثنين من الطقم، ويحاول يعمل ماستيكيشن سلولي، وان هو ياخد سمول بايت بسمول بايت، ما ينفعش يحط كميه كبيره مره واحده. وفي نفس الوقت ان الدينشر دوت بيبقى عايز ان هو الوقت بتاع الشيوك بتاعته الافشنسي بتاعت الارتفيشال تيس غير خالص الافشنسي بتاعت الناتشرال تيس، هي تقريبا بتبقى حوالي السدس بتاعها، فبالتالي لازم ياخد وقت اكتر في الايتنج بتاعه. كمان ان البيشنت دوت هيحس في البدايه ان السبيتش بتاعته او الكلام بيطلع بصعوبه جدا، ولكن ان هو مع ان هو التعود وان هو كل يوم يقعد يقرا شويه ان فرونت اوف ميرور او هو يقرا بصوت برونونسد مسموع، حبه حبه السبيتش بتاعه مش هيبقى فيه اي مشكله، وهيقدر يتكلم احسن مره عن مره. كمان عن الدينشر هايجين، ان طبعا الدينشر دوت موجود في الاورال كافيتي، فلازم يبقى فيه هايجين ليه هو والاندرلاينج تيشو، لازم ينظف الطقم بتاعه اكتر من مره في اليوم، يستخدم سوفت براش، والاحسن طبعا علشان ما يحصلش ان الطقم يحصل له بريكج ممكن يجيب رابر باول او يجيب طبق بلاستيك ويحاول ينظفه جواه في الحوض علشان ما يحصلش فراكشر ويقع منه. في نفس الوقت ان هو ما يستخدمش هوت ووتر وما يستخدمش محلول او اي انتسيبتيك كلين او ان كلينزر فيه مثلا كلور او فيه اي ديترجنت ممكن افكت على الماتيريال بتاعت الاكريل. ان الدينشر ده ما ينفعش يتلبس ات نايت ات اول، لان لازم ندي ريست للتيشو اللي هو الدينشر قاعد عليه طول النهار ان هو اسيوم الناتشر بتاعته ويحصل له ريست، فبالتالي ما يحصلش فيه سورنس او يحصل فيه انفلاميشن. كمان ان الاندرلاينج تيشو ده لازم يتنظف زي ما هو بينظف الاورال كافيتي بتاعه، لازم ينظف الفيدنج سيرفس بتاع الطقم وينظف الميكوزا اكتر من مره، يعني تقريبا كل ما البيشنت هيعمل الايتنج او شيوينج لازم هينظف الاورال كافيتي، يعمل رينسينج ويعمل او يستخدم ماوس ووش. في نفس الوقت الهايجين بتاعه الطقم ذات نفسه، احنا اتفقنا ان الطقم ما بيتلمس ات نايت، فبالتالي لازم الطقم ده يتعام في حاجه هايجينيك، لازم يتغسل كويس جدا وبعدين يحطه في كوبايه او في باول فيها موتر بس او ديس انفكتنت ايجن او انتيسيبتيك سوليوشن زي الحاجات الكوميرشال كتير اللي موجوده. وطبعا ان احنا لازم نقول للبيشنت ان الفولو اب ده حاجه مهمه جدا، ان طبعا في اي وقت ممكن يحصل سورنس او الجزء يحصل له بين تحت الدينشر، ان هو ان البيشنت لو حس باي بين ما ينفعش يعمل ادجستمنت للدينشر اتسلف بنفسه، لازم ان هو يكول الدنتست ويروح يعمل له ادجستمنت. في نفس الوقت لو حصل ان هو في بين او سورنس موجود او البيشنت شال الطقم، لازم يتأكد او يعني شال الطقم قبل الفيزيت اللي هيروحها، لازم يلبسه قبلها على الاقل بوان اور علشان يعرف الجزء اللي عامل له بين او الجزء اللي عايز يعمل له ادجستمنت. After adjustment, warm saline or warm mouthwash is recommended to heal sore spots. أفضل أنت يعني mouthwash ممكن يستخدمه العيان اللي هو المية والملح. وفي الآخر أتمنى أن ما كنتش طولت عليكم.